Hello, Dark Souls fans, and welcome back to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and there's a couple small items of business to be taken care of before we move on, because I realize I'm missing some stuff. So first off, something I noticed.
Dark Soul. The eyes show a world destitute of fire. A barren plain of endless darkness. A place born of betrayal. So, I willed myself, Lord, to link the fire, to paint a new vision. What is thine intent? The eyes, what? I took the mantle of Lord of Cinder of mine own volition. I speak these words with pride. Choose thy fate alone. Seize it with thine own hands. All the more should thy fate entail such foul betrayal.
Okay, so basically Lilith's trying to guilt me. Whatever. I also realized I forgot to talk to Patches in a while.
Oh, hello again. Welcome to Patches' Boutique of Wonders. Can't resist it, can you? My sumptuous selection. We're just a couple of outcasts. Let's make the best of it. Can't find it. Oh, you could.
Well, actually, hang on. I didn't even look. Hey, unlimited human pine resin. That's really nice, actually. I might keep that in mind. Anyway, I wanted to see if they had anything to say about Grey Rat, but apparently no, they don't. Oh well, they wanted to talk to Grey Rat at some point, but Grey Rat's dead. I guess they don't know that. Oh well, anyway. That's part of the business. Another part of the business is I actually forgot some soul descriptions and I used them up and I feel really bad about it. So let's go over some soul descriptions I haven't used up yet. First off, the Dancer Soul. I forgot to read this out, but I haven't used it yet. Soul of the Dancer, one of the twisted souls, steeped in strength. Used to acquire many souls or transposed to extract true strength. The Pond of Sullivan bestowed a double slashing sword upon a distant daughter of the former royal family, ordering her to serve first as a dancer and then as an outrider knight, the equivalent to exile. So I was right that the dancer was actually female. And the next thing is the soul of consumed Osiris, because, yeah, kind of forgot about that one. The soul of Osiris, the consumed king, one of the twisted souls steeped in strength. Used to acquire numerous souls or transposed to extract strength. I've got to skip that every time. Osiris went mad trying to harness his royal blood for a greater purpose, leading him to the heretics of the Grand Archives, where he discovered the twisted worship of Seath the Pale Drake. And then soul champion Gundyr. Once a champion came late to the festivities and was greeted by a shrine without fire and a bell that would not toll. So yeah, that was kind of... I forgot those before I went and used them. But it all works out. Anyway, the other thing is, I've, just in case you're wondering, I do actually rewatch the old episodes. And I noticed in one of the episodes as I was walking across the bridge, there was a sign that went, "Touch for cooperation." And I totally missed it. Because as a rule, I ignore summoning signs. As I mentioned before, I don't really summon help all that often, so I don't usually look at them too often. But yeah, might as well look at this one. Oh, Answer Sirius the Sun of the Realms. Haven't seen her in a while. Sure, let's go help out. Let's help people! Well, AI-controlled NPCs. I guess they're people too. Hey. Sirius has a similar kind of skirt as I do. Creighton the Wanderer. Well, that's a familiar sight. Creighton was an NPC back in Dark Souls 2, but... Ow, come on, seriously? Okay. Oh, crap. Don't you dare kill Sirius! Ah! on, let me backstab you, for crying out loud. Why can't I backstab you? Well, whatever, I got the stamina. Why is it so hard to roll away from this guy? Oh, this is tiring. Why do they let NPCs heal? Like, seriously, why are NPC invaders allowed to heal? That just takes for bloody ever. That's all it does. Like, there's a reason why it's sort of an honor code thing to not heal up, because otherwise the fights just take forever. Oh, finally. Sheesh.
Thank you for your kind assistance. Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
Part of this group. Well, you're welcome. All right. Sheesh, that was harder than I expected. Because, I mean, that was something that I could have done probably after doing the Pontiff Beast, because, yeah, because, like, episode 41 was when I had it, and that was around the time that I think was re-exploring Irithyll a little bit, so it might have been a bit later, but, yeah. Oh, well. Moving on. So, I do want to see if she's popped back to Firelink, because usually if you help people, they'll pop back to Firelink and say hi, and then you can say hi, and then talk to them, and interesting things will happen. Hey, there she is.
I have not thanked you for your generous rescue. That dark spirit was one of Rosaria's fingers. Vile, bastard offspring who lurk in the darkness. My sworn enemies. Fearsome invaders, to say the least. I would not have made it alone. You have my deepest gratitude. If you require help on your travels, I offer you my sign. Blessing of the moon upon your journey. If you recall.
Okay, so I probably was meant to do that a long time ago and totally forgot. Now, what about this Rosaria's Fingers guy, since I've found Rosaria's Fingers?
Now in vain.
Oh, never mind. So, let's read off the stuff we got. Silver Cat Ring is familiar, that's from Dark Souls 2. Reduces fall damage. Silver Ring depicting a leaping feline prevents damage from falling. In the Age of Gods, or possibly just following it, an old cat was said to speak with a human tongue, with the voice of an old woman and the form of a fanciful immortal. Okay, Dark Souls 3 takes place after Dark Souls 2. Calling it now, the cat they're referring to is Sweet Shalquar. That's the cat. That's the old cat that was said to speak with a human tongue with the voice of an old... Well, wasn't really that old. But yes, that was the cat. They're talking about Shalquar. This takes place way later than 2. If anyone was wondering, that's pretty much confirming it. What was the other thing I got? I got, like... Did I get a head... I didn't get armor, did I? No, I got a rapier or something. Mailbreaker, that's what it was. I got Mailbreaker. There it is. Hard, edgeless sword can pierce through tough armor and boasts a deadly critical attack. All right. So now, on to the stuff I actually wanted to look at, which is wherever I get to from that gesture. Well, this is different. This is rather different. These graves are just mounds. Man, it reminds me of the Nightmare Frontier from Bloodborne. I mean, if that was said, the mix of Dark Souls 1 and Bloodborne references, this is another Bloodborne reference, maybe? Archdragon Peak. Oh, crap. Oh, what the heck is with your face? Oh, I just realized I have Atonement still attuned. I don't need that. I have Atonement attuned. I was helping some people out with Champion Gundyr fight, and when you're doing co-op, you need that spell because that draws enemies to you. But what I really want is Wrath of the Gods. I'll put that on later. Lightning Gem. Okay, that makes sense. Although it seems like, for whatever reason, in 3, lightning is now what dragons use, rather than what you use against dragons. It's kind of odd. I mean, the description of lightning, the lightning stone plate ring, or the, wait, do I have it? I thought I had a stone plate ring that was like, yellow stone plate ring that was lightning that talked about how knights that were gonna become dragons use it. Although that might be just because dragons have a weakness to lightning, so you'd want to have lightning power. All right, I don't care about you. I can see you. Where are the ones that, ow. That was rude. Where are your friends I can't see? That's what I want to know. You must have friends I can't see. I can't see them. I guess that goes without saying, but I can't at all. I'd rather like to see them. Well, I can tell you're baiting. There they are. How'd that hit me? Okay, that should not have hit me. These hitboxes are weird. Ah. Great, I figured that would happen. That fire is really bizarrely shaped. Not sure what to expect from it, but okay, whatever. Oh crap, there's no bonfire here. I can't reattune my spells. At least my Estus keeps going. But not being able to reattune spells is not good. Sheesh, that is a scary shuttle. I feel like this might be serious mode. There's a lot of fire coming in. Put on the serious hat. It really only massively improves my defense to fire. It doesn't really improve my physical defense all that much. Or physical absorption, rather. Which, as I mentioned before, that's the stat that matters. Oh, what? He hasn't fired into home as much. All right, there we go. Took a couple tries. Probably shouldn't be playing this while tired. I just really wanted to see what was beyond the point. And now I do know it's beyond the point. It's a lot of annoying robed dragon-y things. Not really dragons. I mean, dragons are usually a bit larger and more winged. But they're kind of like dragons. Contraption does not move. I guess it's shortcut to be acquired later. Oh well. Let's see what's beyond there. Oh, bonfire. Yay! Oh wait, crap. It's right next to enemies. Thanks a lot, game. Oh, so it is. You know what, whatever. We'll deal with him. If I don't have to have atonement, that's better at least. Nope. Do I have to deal with these though? No, apparently not. I mean, the shortcut, I already know, is a shortcut that I can't get to. So, yay, the bonfire is not poorly placed. And also, yay, I have enough Titanite chunks to upgrade my longsword! Which I should probably do at some point. I'll do it between episodes. I don't really need to do it in any hurry. Alright. More of you. More Titanite chunks! Yay! More levers! I'm relatively neutral on that, actually. It's probably a good thing. Wow. Ow. Ah, there we go. I really wonder what these enemies are supposed to be. Also wonder if that one was a one-shot. Probably not. Probably it was multiple shots. Usually one-shots you know because they'll drop some unique item when you kill them. Which that particular enemy did not. Alright, so is that bell tolling because I'm here? Is that an alarm? I hope that's not an alarm. I should have listened when it said try left. I should have looked when it would say try left. I mean, I didn't die, but still. How many embers do I have? I've got enough embers. Let's get more health. Okay. Oh! Huh. So, are you just gonna stand there, or is this gonna be... No, you're just gonna stand there from the looks of it. Ow. Wow. I wish I'd put a... What?! All right. That's not good. plunging attack? Alright, let's try to figure this out. First off, I want to see if this is something I need, because this might be like Storm Ruler. No, it's not like Storm Ruler. Unless, of course, I'm supposed to use the Storm Ruler sword. Nope. Okay. Unless they're saying, oh hey, that's Calamite attack. Unless what they're saying is the dragon will use a plunging attack on you. That's gotta be a trick to this fight. Other than, man, you better wish you had Lightning Spear on hand. Which I'm guessing is not the trick. Hey, game? Game? Wait, what is that? Ow. There's a bell here. That's gotta mean something, right? Alright, it's gonna probably not hit me. Ow. Roll into it, why don't you? Wow. I really feel like I'm missing something. Like, I feel like there's something that I need to have that I don't have, or that I need to pick up in the boss fight, but they already did that trick. The Storm Ruler fight already happened? Oh wait, that's the thing? There's an item I missed up here. Oh, there was a unique enemy. Oh no, it's not. It's right there. I wouldn't mind me grabbing this Ancient Dragon Great Shield. Let's see. A wooden shield bearing the ancient of an ancient dragon very slowly regenerates HP. The painting is a result of an exquisite but painstaking technique. Lingering, undying traces of the ancient dragons can still be seen in their descendants, the Man-serpents, though they have fallen far from grace. Oh, right, Man-serpents, right. Think Sen's Fortress. Got it. All right, well. Go for Lightning Spear. Phantom required ahead. How am I supposed to plunging attack? I mean, okay, plunging attack's a great idea, but from where, I might ask? Eat lightning! Hey, that's damage. Not much damage. Okay, I have no idea how to avoid that attack. But I can have you eat lightning. How's that sound? You aimed. It's cheating. Oh, wait a sec. I know what I'm doing wrong. Or not. I was thinking because it just occurred to me, the first time you ever use plunging attack in Dark Souls is a fight that actually has a ladder that allows you to use a plunging attack. Like, you climb up the ladder and you drop down a plunging attack. And it occurs to me, this is actually a fairly large arena. Maybe something of that nature exists here. Oh, would you just not? I've got stuff to deal with here that doesn't involve you. I recommend dashing through. All right, I think I have something, an idea of what I'm supposed to do. Gotta think Tower Knight from Demon Souls, even though I haven't played that game. But yeah, that's what I gotta think about. Enemies, kill the enemies, I guess. Maybe. Doesn't like I just kill the dragon directly, though. I mean, it would take a lot of lightning spears, but it seems possible. Yeah. I guess we'll just be doing the standard. I don't know if I want to do the standard death montage. Do one more try of actually running through and trying to deal with the stuff beyond the dragon. And then we'll go to the normal death montage. Ow. No ladders up here. Ah, shoot. Man, the hitbox for that is really hard to figure out. One more of actually exploring around. I haven't even shown everything here yet. Thank you, message. Okay, I get it. Close the message. I feel like this is going to be exactly one plunging attack, and then I win. Like, there's all this stuff I'm doing going around the entire boss arena, going up the boss arena. It makes me think that I'm supposed to... How did I not hit you? Screw it. Eat number, I've already picked up one. Ow. Okay, that simply cleared an area. What? Okay, that does hit the wall. I want to deal with both of these at once, but clearly this is not productive. That explains the comment about plunging attacks. There we go. Okay, so there is a way of doing it. And we go somewhere again. Man, I hope I picked up all the items. I'm guessing I did, but I don't know. All right, well, that was a bit of a pain, but it all worked out, so I don't know what's talking about ring ahead. But anyway, that was that bit of an annoying boss fight. I can't believe the plunging attack failed so many times. Like, seriously, plunging attacks used to be more reliable. At any rate, that's gonna be it for this episode, so thanks for watching, and see you next time.